In this video, we're going to look at the new clock app we have on the Mac. This was introduced with macOS Ventura. It's basically the same app that we have on the iPad and iPhone. We have our world clock, which can help us when we want to see what time it is in another time zone. We can all use this with our Zoom meetings. And then we also have our timer as well as our stopwatch. Let's take a look at this new clock app on the Mac. Let's go to my Mac. Now the clock app is located in your applications folder. So let's go and open up my applications folder. I click on the finder and then we go over to applications. You're going to see clock here. Again, this was introduced with macOS Ventura. So if you're using an older version of macOS, you won't be able to see this. So this is the clock app. We can see we have our world clock. We have our alarm. We also have our stopwatch and timer. So it's pretty basic, but I have actually found that I am using this more than I thought I would. How? Well, I host webinars on a regular basis. Some of these are for groups that are in different time zones. So now what I'm able to do, I work with Alaska User Group on a semi-regular basis. I'm able to add a clock for their time zone because I'm in the Eastern time zone and now I can easily see what time it is so I don't miss a meeting, which I have done in the past. So now I can actually see what time it is there so I know when I have to be on in that meeting. So to add a new world clock, all you have to do is just click on the plus, you type in the city, and it'll add it down towards the bottom here. We can rearrange these, drag them around. If I want to remove one, I just click on the X. And of course, we have our world clock up here, so I can see that the sunset is going to, or the sun is going to rise here soon. I also have alarms here. To add an alarm, I just click on the plus, and I can add an alarm. What we can do is set it to repeat, we can add a label to it, and then we can also snooze it and set the sound for it. Basically the same thing that we have with our iPhone and iPad. We also have a stopwatch, so maybe you're working on something on your Mac, and what you need to do is set a timer or a stopwatch for it. Not a timer, we're going to talk about timer here shortly, but a stopwatch. Well, now you can do that right from the Mac. All you do is just click on start, and then when it's running, you can also check lap times. And then if you want to start a timer, you can do that as well. I just set my time here, what the sound is going to be, and then I click on start. And we can see that our timer is going here. To end it, I just click on done. So as I said, it's pretty basic with what you can do, but I'm surprised that I am actually using this more than I thought I would. I basically use the world clock, which is really a surprise to me. I wouldn't think that I'd be using the world clock, but it really does come in handy. But also what I found is I also use the timer in some cases. So it is actually quite convenient to have this on the Mac, not thinking that it would be. So that's the new clock app that we have on the Mac. Again, this was introduced with macOS Ventura, so if you're using an older version of macOS, you will not have this app.